there to seen but not heard. Nowadays, of course, parents have some different problems. Kids might be there, but physically, they are indeed somewhere else. And the way you can tell that is your heads are down, ping, ping, as texts come in, but there's utter silence. Now, the way that mom brings the family to the table, she cuts the cell network, just like in the old days used to cut the telephone lines. And so, this silent break doesn't talk strangers. And it's not because, oh, he's not introduced. No, it's because he was out free. What about this stiff walking or moving stuff? Again, because of when I was a kid. You see, I think my parents were probably setting me up to eat with royalty or something like that. But table manners were high on their agenda. And we're not just not talking about cutlery, you know, work from the outside in. That's beginner stuff, right? It came to body parts. If you dare put an elbow on the table, well, you never hear of it until this evening. How did this break turn out as an adult? Well, let's start when break was in the Canadian Navy. First thing you might wonder is that Canadian Navy. I do not want to dispel any fake news, however, yes, there is indeed a Canadian Navy. Anyway, Navy might be good for break because, well, they do a lot of marching, so they kind of stiff sort of people, right? Not so fast. See, with break, being stiff was also accompanied by being challenged from a, shall we say, a coordination perspective. Let me demonstrate. You see, when you're marching, or indeed walking briskly, the arm goes with the opposite leg. It's a bit like this, right? Pretty easy. Just don't think too much. And there I was, standing in Parade Square with other junior officers, waiting for the drill sergeant to call our names. It was alphabet going through the scale. I could hear my name coming. I was getting kind of nervous, and yes, I was thinking too much. Henry, march. Off it went. That right arm, going with the right leg, the entire way around the painful Parade Square. And 30 years later, I still remember that unfortunate experience. Could not talk. Walked, was being challenged coordination-wise. That is indeed turned into Brig of today, who's in the office. And I used to wear a suit and tie. Yes, any millennials here, people actually used to wear suits to the office. However, dress codes of the 21st century have to drag me kicking and screaming into wearing casual attire to the office. However, I still occasionally have to admit I bring in a sports jacket saying it's cold out there. But in any case, I seem to be getting away with that. Back in the day when people actually used to talk on the telephone, my partner used to call me at the office. And of course, I'd always answer, hello, right here. And so he related to me a number of years later. He said, you know, I was really wondering what I was getting involved here with this hello breaker stiff guy. Any case, years transpire and we're still together, but fortunately for the relationship, texting came along. Problem solved.